cherishing our women no matter what it takes. That is my message to the American people. That is why I'm letting Miss Vanessi make her farewell appearance in this little show of yours, The Taming of the Shrew. I like the title, and I like what it has to say.
The chain of command and family life.
Right again, Graham. I'll wait in Miss Vanessi's quarters.
Upstairs, first door you come to, General.
On stage, Mr. Graham.
Why, General! Sergeant Lane reporting for duty!
All right, driver. Wait outside. Mount your vehicle.
Well, don't you remember the Sydney Harbour Bridge? I had something in my eye and you took me to Hong Kong to take it out.
Now, how could I forget?
Oh, I still have that diamond bracelet with the rubies. Oh, I think of you all the time when I go to my safe deposit box.
Yeah, now, look here, Laura.
Lois,
of course, Lois. That was war. And after the hell of battle, a soldier needs his rest and recreation.
Well, I remember the recreation. I don't remember the rest.
But that was hot. But now is peacetime. I'm about to marry my Lois.
Your Lois?
My Lily. Lily Vanessi. The institution of marriage is sacred.
Oh, I know. I heard you on the radio. Oh, permission to go on stage, General.
Do your duty, Sergeant. However, here's my card. Get in touch after a decent interval, say 3 months.
Why, General?
You may need some earrings to go with that bracelet. I shall return!
When did you initiate the United States Army?
What a thing to say. I assure you, there was nothing wrong between he and I. Just because a girl's good-hearted and normal and patriotic and wants to get along with her fellow man. I'm just mad.
assemble, 1400 hours. Guests arrive at the cathedral, 1430 hours. Over the top with the bishop, 1500 hours. Press conference, 1530 hours. Then onward to LaGuardia, depart 1630. Got that? Arrive Washington, advance on White House, 1745 hours. Meet with President, give him answer, and honeymoon with wife.
Into battle, eh, General?
Detail, Graham, detail. That's the secret of total victory.
Harrison, thank God you're here.
Those are your orders, Major.
Oh, no, don't hang up, darling. I'm playing the show under duress. Call the FBI.
Now, my dear, I accept. No, I positively enjoy the caprices of a woman of talent and beauty whom I happen to adore.
Oh, what caprices? But, darling, these thugs threatened me.
Now, my dear.
They're making me play at the point of the gun. They won't let me leave the theater.
Are you referring to the two most promising graduates of the group theater? Why, these men have dedicated their lives to truth and beauty.
Truth!
Beauty!
Can't you see they're gangsters?
I guess it shows.
What can one say to lie?
Should I say something?
No. Discretion is the better part of valor. Famous Emmys, top shelf, underdone fiction, right-hand corner, Atlanta. No talking, no smoking.
Harrison, darling, listen to me. I can't get out of this theater. These thugs won't let me.
My dear, you're straining my patience. Judging by their costumes and their education, they are obviously not what you say they are.
But darling, they have guns.
I should hope so. The right to bear arms is enshrined in our Constitution.
But they're waving them around. I could get killed.
Dearest, guns don't kill people.
We do.
General, allow me. You'll really want to go, go. You want to leave the theater if that's what you want to do. I can't say I blame you. What is there to hold you here? What is 10% of the gross compared to general housekeeping and a dress allowance?
A generous dress allowance, Graham. People respect a uniform.
Hear that, Lillian? All that meaningless excitement, the thunderous applause of the crowd, pictures in the paper, the parties, the adoration. I can't say I blame you for leaving all that when you have a chance at happiness, real happiness, under the general.
Good thinking, Graham. I believe I know how to make a woman happy.
God bless
you,
sir.
I never want to see in this theater again. Or you again. I have a whole new life now with the most adorable man in the world.
And the President of the United States agrees with you, dearest one. Truman has asked me to be his running mate in November.
Oh, darling, you said yes.
Hold your horses. Dewey's also asked me to be his running mate.
Oh, goodness. Dewey or Truman? What a decision.
I told Dewey yes. I know a winner when I see one. And I want you right there on the campaign trail beside me. My little running mate.
Running here, running there.
Dewey will do one term, and I'll do the next. Thank you, Graham. I think I know how to make the little woman happy.
Oh, dearest. Let me throw something on and we can leave this tawdry dressing room forever. Oh, take me somewhere magical where we can dine by candlelight.
A little late for dinner, dearest one.
Oh, but darling, I just finished a show. I am starving.
Half a show. That's worth a plate of soup.
Lily, if the war taught me anything, it's no rations after 2100 hours. Be good to your liver, and your liver will be good to you.
The general's right, for it engenders choler and planted anger. 'Twere better that both of you should fast.
Oh, but darling, I bought the most enchanting hat to go out with you tonight. It's French.
Lily, fancy foreign headwear? That's not what America wants to see on the top of a future first lady.
Thou sayest true, 'tis a paltry cap. I love thee that thou likest it not.
Tis lewd and filthy.
Be gone, take it hence!
Oh. But darling, my entire wardrobe is Dior. And come November in Nebraska, I'm going to need my new book, Meek.
Forgive me, my dear, but what the voters will want to see you in is a good old Republican cloth coat. Now, we better get moving.
true. Now let him speak.
Tis charity to show.
Can you give me Mr. Hogan? I got a question I gotta ask him. Mr. Hogan likes it when I check in. Come on, Gumpy, you know the rules.
Hey,
what do you mean I gotta call you Mr. Gumpy now? Now just put Mr. Hogan on the phone, it's not that, why are you being so... Oh.